So before I begin today, I want you to think about your own cloud cost management journey. As we're talking to different people at the show, we're seeing that there's a wide range of sophistication within their FinOps practices, cloud cost management practices. Some businesses are just starting to begin to think about cloud cost management. Some businesses have very sophisticated set cost centers of excellence or dedicated FinOps teams. But I want you to think about where your business is. The FinOps Foundation, it's part of the Linux Foundation. They offer a great model for managing your cloud cost strategy. And it actually consists of three phases, six domains, 18 capabilities, and three maturity levels across each: crawl, walk, and run. So as you're thinking about what your level of sophistication is across each of these things, you can kind of put it in that context. So regardless of where you actually are with your level of sophistication, today you're going to learn how to empower all of your FinOps stakeholders with clarity and highly personalized insights. We're going to explore how to develop your AWS cloud financial management strategy to minimize noise and maximize the relevance between your FinOps practice and your business objectives. We're going to look at the relationship between FinOps and business value. We'll discuss how, above all, FinOps is about relationships and why insight is critical to driving collaboration. We'll talk about what makes a FinOps insight valuable and how we deliver and develop the insights we give you at Anodot. And we'll explore ways to drive increased clarity across your organization to grow your AWS value. So what's the value of FinOps anyway? Folks mistakenly think that it's all about scrutinizing and reducing the cloud bill, but it's actually not. At Anodot, we believe the value of FinOps is all about driving increased revenue from your AWS investment. FinOps accelerates the value you get from AWS, yes, by helping you to reduce costs, but by primarily shifting the culture of your organization from one of traditional silos to one that is collaborative. To enable that shift, the FinOps Foundation recommends three phases, which we align here at Anodot. The first phase is inform. We call this visibility. This is all about enabling every stakeholder to understand their costs and how they relate to your business. On the finance side, we see that this often is a place where your FinOps strategy might break down, and we'll talk a little bit how to get over that challenge. Secondly is optimization. This is understanding how to and actually using the cloud more efficiently. On the engineering side, we see this is where FinOps initiatives can also break down. And actually, we've heard some real horror stories, usually caused by a lack of empathy between finance and engineering. We'll talk a little bit about how to fix that today. The third is operate. We call this monitoring. This is all about achieving highly sophisticated and predictable cloud operations where you can look ahead with a great deal of accuracy and you're never surprised by your cloud bill. And yes, we've actually added a fourth. The FinOps Foundation doesn't have this, but we think that it's important to not wait to start improving your cloud financial management strategy. You need to start today. So that's the value of FinOps, but can we boil FinOps down into some kind of like a secret sauce? So the FinOps Foundation defines FinOps as a framework of people, principles, and phases of action, and says at its core, FinOps is a cultural practice. That's the people in your organization and how they work together to leverage AWS for organizational success. In fact, the first five principles of FinOps are all about people. But each of these personas is different. They have different needs, goals, and pain points. Business management wants to track and show the impact of cloud costs on investment on revenue. Finance wants accountability, and they want a guarantee that the cloud is being used ever more prudently. And DevOps wants to achieve operational efficiency and deliver higher service quality. So what's one thing you can deliver to all of these personas to empower better FinOps? What's the electricity to run your FinOps engine? It's insight. It's helping the right people know the right thing at just the right time. And not coincidentally, that's what we're totally focused on at Anodot. So insights could take a lot of forms. What makes a good insight? I've identified a few qualities here that we leverage at Anodot. The first is timely. You want insights to be just in time and to arrive when they're actually actionable. Accurate. The fastest way to lose all credibility is to provide any kind of inaccurate information. Precision is critical. Meaningful. Insights can't be trivial. Is it a meaningful anomaly that you've detected, or is it just noise? Automated. Yes, there's a place for dashboards and reports and occasionally doing a project-driven deep dive into something in your infrastructure, but generally you want insights to come to you autonomously. And finally, accessible. You want insights to be easy to understand and manage, and an accessible insight means that your team can generalize versus becoming an expert on one core area of FinOps. Also, you'll be able to avoid costly professional services contracts, and you won't need to spin up an entire data science team to develop and maintain algorithms for anomaly detection and forecasting. So a side effect of this powerful insights is that it's actually a shortcut to run level competency across all the phases of FinOps. So if it's as easy as providing insights, what's stopping all organizations from achieving this FinOps nirvana? Well, there's two places that FinOps efforts traditionally stall. For finance teams, it's generally during the inform phase. And for DevOps teams, it's generally during the optimization phase. And this is, like I mentioned, usually caused by a little bit of a lack of empathy between the two departments. In fact, the FinOps Foundation has, in their annual survey for the past 2 years, has identified somewhat insensitively worded getting engineers to take action as the number one reported issue amongst companies trying to achieve FinOps. So there's definitely a lack of understanding between the two groups. Better insights can fix this. One of our customers, a mid-sized IT security company, has over 120 users of our product that are active across all these different departments, finance, DevOps, engineering, and the business. We also find with our optimization recommendations, there's a very high rate of adoption. So we're helping to break down this challenge, and we see similar behavior to that in all of our customers. So when I talk to FinOps practitioners, there's one other big issue I hear about a lot. With many FinOps tools, initially you'll see a tremendous amount of value, but over time you'll see that value and usage tend to decrease and drop significantly. At Anodot, we call this the wall. I'm also going to talk about how you can vault this with better insights. Another one of Anodot's customers that's a long-time customer just saved over $1 million in the last quarter due to operationalizing our insights. We also see a very high rate of renewal. So we don't see this wall amongst our customers where value kind of drops off, but I'm going to talk a little bit about how insight can also help you achieve ongoing value as well. So I'm also going to talk a little bit about why our customers might not be hitting this wall. And that's because we focus on insights that are not just powerful, but also highly relevant to the people, these personas. When insights are people-focused, they enable collaboration with the right audience getting the right information at the right time. They enable a shared language so departments can communicate effectively. At one of our customers, Aqua Security, and others, they volunteer that engineering, business, and finance are all able to share a common language with the Anodot platform to collaborate. And finally, when insights are relevant to each persona, you can develop and achieve performance metrics to show progress and real value growth due to AWS. One thing we focus on at Anodot is tracking, among other things, which of our recommendations you implement and the dollar value of that. So we're very big on KPI enablement. So what are some practical, tactical things you can do to start delivering persona-driven insights? Start with AWS. Start with AWS. We find that all of our customers have started with the AWS native tools, and they're actually very powerful. We also find that across the industry, folks are underutilizing AWS's native cost management capabilities significantly. They have some great resources, so I'm going to give you a couple high-level tips. The first is to understand and leverage Cost Explorer fully. The tool keeps getting better. There was recently a new release that was great, and I think it's got a lot of promise going forward. Take advantage of the the well-architected dashboards, especially the Kudos dashboards to deliver insight and visibility for your teams. This can get you a lot of the way to what we deliver from an insight perspective, at least for AWS. You want to make sure you're leveraging AWS budgets and AWS budget actions to control costs. And these last two are actually a reminder to challenge your organization. I think that's an important part of FinOps. You know, I think that engineers can typically pick up finance concepts actually quite easily. And you know, finance practitioners might say, oh, I'm not technical, but with a little bit of knowledge about AWS, they can start to help engineering maybe focus a little bit more on when maybe an ARM-powered instance that's going to have a much lower price might be possible to use, or actually start operationalizing the recommendations from AWS Compute Optimizer. So when you're ready to level up, that's where Anodot comes in. What separates us from other tools that deliver a lot of powerful visibility, including for Kubernetes, from the cluster down to the pod level, is that we focus on enabling you to get the right business insights for any business metric to the right people at the right time. We service a huge range of highly personalized cost recommendations that your team will actually get behind. We help our customers achieve meaningful savings. Thirdly is machine learning-driven monitoring. We have very relevant anomaly detection that separates urgent anomalies from noise. And we have the highest accuracy cost forecasting available with a mind-blowing 98.5% median accuracy. We're also constantly bringing new capabilities focused on people to market. And we're priced affordably. The last thing you want is a tax on top of your AWS budget. And so Anodot's all in on AWS. We're available in the AWS Marketplace. And I'd love if you would all come by and see us at booth 2540. We're down here right by Druva. Or you can visit us online at anodot.com/cloud. So as I conclude, I want you to remember one thing as you go back and pursue better cloud financial management at your organizations. You'll find the most FinOps success if each action you take is done in service of driving collaboration, empathy, and insight for each stakeholder in your organization. Thank you so much.